Hi, I'm Gary. Sentiment analysis, part of natural language programming, or NLP, is very common, very popular, and a very powerful tool. For example, we can see the sentiment, the positive or negative sentiment of someone when they interact with a help desk. Many help desks use NLP to see how their customers interact with their staff and their staff interact with customers. Also, social media, we might be able to tell how positive or negative people are talking about our brand. But let me show you how simple it is to do sentiment analysis in Python. First of all, on my screen, you're going to see my data. These are media releases. I'm going to create sentiment analysis on these media releases. These are media releases from various state governments in Australia over the last few years, health-related media releases. So I'm going to look at the sentiment of this text column. Okay, I've got state, I've got the date, I've got several thousand rows. It's not a huge data set. So what I'm wanting to get to, or what I'll show, what we'll get to, so that's what I'm going to analyze for sentiment. I want to know how positive and negative every one of these media releases are, every single one of these rows. So just to show you where we're actually going with this, we're going to get to here. So you'll notice it's the same as before. That's the text. I'm going to analyze that text column, and we can see whether it's positive or negative. Now, there are various things that happen in this analysis. It gives a positive score, how positive what is each of these text rows, for example, how neutral or how negative is it, and a compounded or an overall score. So generally, we would look at this overall score. So for example, anything above 0, 0 to 1 would be positive, and anything from 0 to minus 1 would be negative. So here you can see that's minus 0.8, so that's a negative sentiment. Critical workers from certain sectors isolating as close contacts will be, and on it goes. So that was deemed as negative, and so on. So let's see how we do this. I'm going to go across to Jupyter Notebook. I do have, if you haven't used Jupyter before, if you need to install Python, I do have a tutorial, and I'll create a link for that. Also, the script I'm running, in this video, in the description of the video, I'll create a link where you can copy this this script and use it if you want to. So we're going to run this. Let me just go through what's happening here. So we're saying, first thing we're going to do is import NLTK. That's an NLP or natural language programming package in Python. We're going to be using the VADER lexicon. VADER is what does the sentiment analysis, which is part of the NLTK. And we're going to use pandas, so good old pandas, which if you're a data scientist or data analyst, you probably use pandas a lot. If you use Python, it creates data frames, or we can work with data frames, let's put it that way. So we're going to load up the CSV file into the pandas data frame. I'm then going to do a little bit of work on it. For example, I'm going to drop in or drop all columns, all where the date column is empty. I'm going to drop those. I just want to get rid of those empty columns. It's just something that's probably good practice to do. I'm then also going to define the various data types. You don't necessarily need to do this, but I will just to show you. So I've got a date column, a text column, and a state column. Date is date, text is text or a string. And a state is actually categorical. In pandas, particularly if you're working, if you're a researcher, for example, and working with large data sets, several million rows, for example, that would destroy Excel, for example, you're going to use far less memory if you define the data types. Generally, what happens is using pandas, it imports the data as an object type, similar to string. And you'll notice that you will have you may well have memory problems. But if you define the data types, your memory usage will go down. So I've just gotten in the habit of doing it, so I'm going to do it in this case. You don't need to do it with smaller lots of data. So let me just run this. And we should see, because I've said here, print the head. show the first few and the last few rows. We can see here, I've got, it's not quite line, but date, I've got text, and I've got state. Okay, so I've loaded it up. Now we're going to create that magic. We're going to run that sentiment analysis and create those extra fields in my Excel file or CSV file, save it to a CSV file. So I'm going to go through it very, very quickly. We're going to load up the analyzer. We're then going to create four different columns, compound, negative, neutral, and positive, and VADER is going to calculate that for us, the different scores, based on the text column in our data. My different columns, I'm going to create as well a sentiment column, because I want to just summarize these. So what I'm going to say is, if the positive score is greater than 0.5, then make it positive. Sorry, if the sentiment score is greater than 0.5, add positive into the sentiment field. If in the sentiment field, the compound value is less than negative 0.05, then add negative. It's just a very quick way of then seeing positive and negative scores. And we'll just print it out to the screen and we'll save it to a CSV file ending in demo.csv, just so I can show you that it's done. So let's run this. Now this does take a little bit of time to run. For the amount of data that I have, which is 2,204 rows, it'll take, I'm guessing, 3 minutes or so on my computer, which is pretty slow. If you have several million rows, it'll obviously take a lot longer. It's quite a complex thing, but I'll get back as soon as this is finished. We'll carry on. Okay, so the sentiment analysis or the script has now run, and you can see here I've printed to the screen the first value there, 52, is there 52 neutral comments, 1,572 positive, and 580 negative. So in general, the media releases that the health departments in the data that I have were inherently mostly positive. But let's go now to that CSV file and just make sure that it's entered the data as we expected. So going across to that file, this is the one there. I'll just open that up. We'll just wait for that to load up in Excel. I'll just make it a little bit bigger so we can see. So there my column headers are, and you'll notice that now it's added the compound, negative, neutral, positive, and the general sentiment. Of course, now you could create a chart if you want to in Excel or even using Python. But please subscribe to my channel. Please like this video. I'm Gary.